Hey guys, many of you might think I have reviewed every GK keyboard out there, but the GK96S was released just recently via Ipo Maker. It features a 96% layout, supports Bluetooth, has hot swap capabilities, and more. It's currently available as part of a group buy that ends on December 7, 2020, so let's see if it's worth considering. But before going further, I wanted to say, I've received a few comments recently regarding a group buy that didn't go well with Durgod, and I unfortunately cannot know in advance if the company will deliver on their promises. I'm only getting keyboards and not going through the group buy process, so I cannot comment on how the company handles it. I've had other Kickstarters with Ipo Maker in the past and haven't heard anything negative about them, but keep in mind that group buys are a bit riskier in nature. So this keyboard comes in a regular GK style box, all grey with the Skylung branding on top. You get a short guide, then the keyboard in plastic wrapping, then replacement keycaps to switch between Mac and Windows specific modifiers, a pack of various switches, a 2-in-1 keycap and switch puller, and a braided USB Type-C cable. All the accessories are very high quality and everything is included to get you started. This keyboard is very similar to the other GK keyboards, just in a larger form factor. The case is all plastic but good quality, it has a matte finish and is quite scratch resistant. It's also super sturdy with no flex at all, very impressive considering the width of this keyboard. One major change compared to past GK keyboards is the addition of flip-out feet, and I'm quite impressed by them. There are two sets of feet for a total of three angle options, and both sets only add a small angle increment, so I would see them as decent angles that people would like. All sets are rubberized, so the keyboard always has a good grip. Finally, there is a USB-C port at the left, and it should accommodate third-party cables with larger connector housings. This keyboard is offered in a bunch of configurations, and the one I was sent is worth $89. You can pick from ABS or PBT keycaps, mechanical or optical switches, and there you can also pick from a variety of switches, some of which come with extra costs. And finally, you can go with the standard layout or with the Southpaw variant where the numpad will be at the left. It's worth noting that if you opt for optical switches, the Southpaw layout is not available, and the name of this keyboard is SK96 in this case. If we look at my unit, it comes with PBT keycaps, has the numpad at the right, and the switches are mechanical instead of optical, and here I have Gateron Browns. I would personally go with this mechanical version for a greater switch selection later on, and then go with the PBT keycaps variant if you like how it looks, otherwise opt for the ABS variant option if you plan on replacing them anyway to save a bit. This layout is called 96% and it's sort of like an extended 65% layout. You get pretty much all keys you would get on a full-size keyboard including a numpad, but in the size of a 10KLS keyboard. To achieve this, they have to make a few compromises here and there compared with a standard NC layout. As an example, right side modifiers are 1 unit wide and the right shift key is 1.75 unit wide instead of 2.75. It's not super hard to get used to, but if you wanted to replace keycaps, you'd have to account for these non-standard keys. Same thing for the function row that also houses navigation keys like page up and page down. Speaking of keycaps, I'm not a fan of this colorway personally, but the quality is pretty good. They are PBT and the legends are dye sublimated. They are pretty thick too. Generally, these are great for the price. On the other hand, the legends are not always centered and sometimes it's very easy to tell. They also feature a profile that's proprietary to GK keyboards, I believe. It's called GK1 and it looks like XDA or DSA, but it's actually sculptured, so the profile is different from rows to rows. It's not hard to get used to, but some keys look a bit weird, like the vertical enter. From the sides, it seems like the two bottom and top rows share the same profile too. Definitely a unique characteristic with this keyboard, and I'm not sure if it's a pro or a con. Under these keycaps hides brown switches. This keyboard also comes with blue, black, and red switches, and for an extra cost, you can get Gateron greens, yellows, silvers, and whites. Here, browns are the only tactile option, so I would probably opt for one of the cheaper options and upgrade to better switches later on. Mainly because this keyboard has hot swap capabilities and it supports 5-pin switches, so the possibilities are endless. Another good option would be to pay an extra for Gateron yellows and loop them for a very good budget linear option. As for the stabilizers, here it's what you would expect from GK keyboards, so they are factory lubed and they generally perform better than most pre-built keyboards with unlubed stabs. Now, as for Bluetooth, this model does support Bluetooth 5.1 and switching between up to 3 devices. You can turn Bluetooth on and off with function plus space, and then pair with Bluetooth-enabled devices by holding down function plus 1, 2, or 3, effectively assigning the device to this number as well. Afterwards, switching between connected devices is only a matter of hitting function plus the assigned number. I haven't tested the Bluetooth connectivity in depth, but it seems lag-free and stable like other recent GK keyboards I've tried. The keyboard can fall asleep automatically or not after some time. This setting can be changed with function plus delete. I would personally set it to off or to a pretty long time, as it does take a few seconds to reconnect, so definitely not the best Bluetooth experience. It's worth noting that it features a 4000 mAh battery, so the battery life should be pretty good, likely a few weeks of power if LEDs are kept off. As with all GK keyboards, this larger variant also comes with RGB LEDs. You can cycle through all the stock animations with function plus the minus key, and cycle through sound or actuation-based effects with function plus the plus key. It's also possible to change the animations with the GK 6X Plus software. This is also the same thing as with other modern GK keyboards. You can have up to 4 custom configurations and switch between them with function plus 5 to 8. Here, the first configuration is tied to the current state of the driver, but the other 3 configurations are stored on board. By default, the first config is Windows and the other one is Mac, but I'm not sure if it's actually correct, as backspace is tied to delete on that config. It's a bit weird. Anyway, you can remap keys but also bind them to other functions like mouse controls, media buttons, core OS functionalities, and more. You can also bind keys to temporary layer switching so you can easily access other layers, but I don't see this being as necessary on a 96% keyboard. Still, a pretty powerful package here. So now to the conclusion. I would definitely recommend this keyboard for folks looking for a budget keyboard with this specific layout. The value is really great, being a sub $100 keyboard with hot swap capabilities, a standard 96% layout, Bluetooth support, and extensive reprogrammability. In terms of downsides, the keycaps are good quality, but the legends are not well centered, and I'm not a huge fan of the only theme it is offered in. And while Bluetooth is supported, waking the keyboard from sleep results in a bunch of missed keys and might have you end up using it wired in the long run, as it can get annoying. Finally, while the keyboard is highly reprogrammable, it's not QMK nor VIA compatible, so you need to rely on the not-so-intuitive Windows-only GK 6X Plus software to do so. All in all, I believe it's a great starter keyboard to build on top of. You can easily replace the switches in the long run and properly lube the stabilizers since the switches are not soldered in. Stock keycaps are decent regarding most aspects, but they wouldn't be too hard to replace either given that this keyboard features a standard 96% layout. So that wraps it up for today. As always, I'll have an affiliate link to this keyboard down below. Feel free to use it if you're interested and want to support the channel at the same time. So, thanks for watching. Make sure you leave a like if you did. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already, as I'll see you in a future video.